Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky back with more progress. Okay, let me show you what we've got going on here. We ended up using the mesh just because we wanted something subtle. And so you see it there, you see the mesh. And of course we ended up using a, what was that we used? We used a Pagan Gold candy base coat. Just to enliven it, okay? We want the roof, the hood, and the trunk to be basically that color against the other gold. So you'll see, I am going to go ahead and untape some of this. You always want to tape your model so that, and I'm using frog tape. It's a good tape for extra masking, okay? And so you wanna remove it as slow as humanly possible. I haven't had any issues whatsoever with this tape in terms of it pulling my paint or the tape that's underneath. But there's always a first for everything. So we're removing it slowly, diligently, and then we have some of that crepe tape that, conforms to curves and stuff like that. So we're, and remember the order also that you put the tape in so that you can remove it one step at a time, moving back. Oh, I'm already liking the fact that we've got the tape on there really well. We masked it right and it went all the way around the edge. Some of this, of course, is going to have... there you go. See, it didn't pull up the tape. Foil, because we have to do the foil all the way around, but you begin to see how it's turning out. Okay, and so you also, you could remove this if you want. Normally I leave it on there just because until I'm done, I don't like to remove it. So there we go. We've got ourselves a nice little pattern started. Now, this is where your tweezers will start coming in, okay? And you have to be very, very careful. You start removing some of that tape, and I hope you could see it. See that shimmering light? That's the gold underneath. So just a little bit at a time, and make sure you do not scratch your paint, or I'm liking that. There's another one right there. So you see it popping, right? You see the shimmer. All of that is going to come through as the gold. So take your time, keep your hands clean, for the next stage, of course, is we are going to tape from the seam down and then work on the sides, and then eventually we have to come back in and mask all of this and do the edges, and we should be done, and we should have a nice paint job after that. We get to clear and buffing and all of that, and then assembly of the model. So it's a long painstaking process, but it's one that's going to bring you lots of smiles and lots of pleasure. So, again, go slow and be methodic. Take breaks, okay? And more importantly, keep your packaging material. I think this came from an onion bag or something like that at the market. So, I hope you've enjoyed it, and we'll be back with more, my friends. All right, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory saying stay tuned in. More eye candy headed your way. Hey, everybody. Dr. Cranky here with a little bit more progress. Let me show it to you. We've got the all the panels, all the graphics, okay? You see the mesh there, kind of, again, subtle. There's more paint coming. There's going to be some candy work over all of that right now. So, you know, we've got a nice foundation there for more paint. And remember, this thing is going to be golden green. It's going to be mostly green, if I can help it. Because it has to match the interior. It has to be. I just love the way that gold comes through, you know, when it catches the light. And you could also see the mesh subtly done on there. So it's, as I said, you know, whatever you tape down, that's going to be the graphic. And I like it. We'll see what happens to the sides. So far, so good. I ended up with a couple of ticks, which again, it's no big deal. You know, when you're doing an elaborate paint job like this, you're going to make mistakes, and you can't drive yourself crazy. You can't be a perfectionist. So the beauty of it is that, you know, you keep a handy micro brush near you, and then you can touch the little nicks or whatever, you know, little scratches, little imperfections with the original base coat color, and you hope, of course, that the candy will absorb it. It doesn't happen all the time. I mean, sometimes a tick is a tick is a tick, and it's there for good. Maybe later on, I don't know, you can, there's that scratch there that if it doesn't go away, it's the perfect spot for a little decal of some sort, you know. So don't throw your paint job into the purple pond just because you've made a couple of little mistakes. Don't do it until the very end. And if it's, you know, blatant and you don't like it, then of course you can do that. But, you know, you've wasted lots and lots of hours. But anyway, that's where we're at. So the series continues. Stay tuned in for more, my friends. More Cranky Show coming your way.